ओके, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. विल स्टार्ट सेशन टुडे. ओके, सो वी हैव बीन डिस्कसिंग कॉर्नोफ मैप सिंप्लीफिकेशन इन द प्रीवियस सेशन. सो दिस सेशन विल ऑल्सो we'll cover Kornoff map and we'll see some additional features in Kornoff map, different ways of simplification and different forms of simplification, and we'll see up to 6 variables. Okay, so in the last session we have seen 2, 3, and 4 variables. So this session we'll see 4 variables, more on 4 variables, and then 5 and 6 variables also we will see. Okay, so what we have seen in the previous session, already we have covered some canonical and standard form conversions and 2 and 3 variables and 4 variable SOP. So this session we will see SOP simplification in POS form. So SOP, what is SOP? Can anyone give me in the chat? Yes, SOP, sum of products. Yes, very good. Very good, Praveen, Raj, Satvika. POS, what is POS? POS? POS is product of sum. Yes, very good. So we will be seeing, given SOP, how to convert it in POS form, and given POS, how to do the simplification. And in addition, we will also see some don't care conditions. So what is don't care and how to do K-map simplification using don't care. And then we'll see 5 and 6 variable K-map simplification. And we'll also see few exercise problems. So this is the agenda for today's session. So a recap of what we have seen in the previous session. So main points that you need to remember for solving K-map, the first 4 points: f, a function, boolean function f, can be represented as sum of all minterms whose function is 1. The other way of representing f is the product of all max terms whose function is 0. So suppose I want to represent in terms of min terms, then it will be summation of min terms of all min terms whose value is 1. And if I want to represent the same function in terms of max terms, it should be the product of all max terms whose value is 0. So a function, boolean function, can be represented in 2 forms, one in min terms and the other one in max terms form. Same way, f complement can also be represented in 2 forms. So f complement, if I want to represent in terms of min terms, it will be sum of min terms whose function value is 0. Same way, if you want to represent f complement in max terms, it should be represented as product of all max terms whose function value is 1. Okay, so these are the 4 points that you have to remember. Given any problem, you should immediately imagine how you can represent f and what is f complement, and if it is represented in min terms and max terms. Okay, you should be able to correlate. So these 4 points are very important, so remember this. Then we also saw K-map grouping. So K-map groups can always in powers of 2. So 2 power 0, 2 power 1, 2 power 2, 2 power 3, likewise it goes. So if you cannot group a 1, in if there is no neighbor, either in the top or bottom or left or right, then it becomes a group of 1. That will be the last option. So always you have to try to form a larger group, and if it is not possible, then you have to try to form smaller groups. So the possible groupings, group count, the number of cells in a group can be 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, and 32. Okay, so suppose it is an three variable K map, you will have totally 8 cells. So the maximum possibility is 8. Suppose you are able to group all the 8s into a single group, then the function value F will be equal to 1. You won't have a product term where you have variables, because why are we able to group everything into 8? Because every cell contains 1. That means F value is equal to 1. It does not depend on the input variables A, B, or C, or X, Y, and Z. Instead, F is always equal to 1. So if you try to group everything, a three variable K map, in a group of 8, then the F value will become 1. Similarly, you can say for four variable, if you group all the 16 cells into a single group, then the F value will be equal to 1. Okay. Then we also saw adjacency. What are the different possible adjacency? Usually your groups that you form will be either in square or in rectangle form. And there is no diagonal grouping. And in addition to square and rectangle, you can also have wraparound adjacency. So what is wraparound adjacency? Can anyone tell in the chat box? Wraparound adjacency. Anyone remember? Wraparound adjacency. Try. What is wraparound adjacency? Square, rectangle, everything is common. What is wraparound adjacency? Yes, do you remember? Grouping cells from top and bottom of the table. Very good, Satvika. Yes, top and bottom and left and right. First column, last column, first row, last row. So that is very good, ma. Wraparound adjacency. So if you are able to group the first column and the last column, and similarly top row and the bottom row, then you call it as wraparound adjacency. So you can imagine just like a cylinder, you either rolled from left to right or top to bottom. And in wraparound adjacency, you have to remember that corners of the cell, of the K-map, are also adjacent to each other. So top left corner is adjacent to top right corner and the bottom left corner. Okay, so all the four corners are adjacent to each other, and if you have four ones and the top corners, then all the four ones can be grouped together into a single group. Okay, so these are the various possibilities we saw for grouping. Then after grouping, we wrote the product terms. So when we write the product term for each group, you have to eliminate, you have to write the common terms and eliminate different variables. So different variables, variables in different forms. So A complement, if it is available in the same group, then you can eliminate them. If A is common for all the cells in the group, you have to retain it in the final product term. So for each and every product term, you will write a group. Every group, you will write a product term. And the final simplified Boolean expression will be a summation of all those product terms. Clear? That is what we saw. So I think we stop with this problem in the last session. So this is, we'll start with our problem now. So it will be a recap for you. So here you are given a problem where you have all the terms as min terms. So it is all summation of min terms, and in the given question itself, we have converted each and every term into its corresponding binary equivalent and its decimal number. So having it in decimal number, it will be easier for you to plot in the K-map. So it is not necessary that you have to convert it into 4, 5, 10, that decimal equivalent. You can directly plot using the min terms, but it will be easier for you to plot in the K-map if you have converted it into decimal numbers. So we'll try solving this. So W, X, Y, Z. So always label the rows and columns so that you don't make mistake when we write the final product. And hope all of you are having a note and pen with you. You have to solve the problems. We'll be solving some 10 to 15 problems in this session. So you have to solve it with me. Yes? Okay. So 0001110, then 0001110, both in the row and the column. Then you number the cells. So 0, 1, 2, and 3. So if you make mistakes in numbering the cell, then it will, everything will go wrong. 6 and 7, then 8, 9, 10, 11, then we have 12, 13, 14, and 15. Okay. Then we will plot. So once you have numbered, then you can plot. And in addition, you can also label the rows and columns with W and X. So for example, you can write W complement, X complement, W complement, X, then W, X, then W, X complement. So that when you write the final product term, you won't make an error. So it will be Y complement Z, then it is YZ, then YZ complement. Now we can plot. So it's a summation of minterms of 4, then 5, then you have 10, then 11, then you have 14 and 15. 4, 5, then 10, 11, 14 and 15. Now you can form a group. So you can see a larger group here, a group of 4. So all these will be forming one group. And the product term for this group will be? Yes, what will be the product term for this group? Can I get the product term for this group in the chat box? Yes, it is W, which is common in the row, and Y. Very good, very good. So it is W, which is common for both the rows in both the rows, and Y is common for both the columns. Okay, then what is remaining? Cells 4 and 5 are remaining. So 4 and 5 you can group together. And what is the product term? You have only one row, so you can take the variable of that row. Yes, W complement X is common. Very good. W complement X, you have these cells in only one row, so it is W complement X. And if you take the column, Y complement is common for both the cells. Yes, Monica, Vandana, okay, very good, ma'am, very good. Okay, so this is your, so WY plus W complement X, XY complement. So this is the answer for your K-map simplification. Yeah. Okay. Okay. So you have one more example before we move on to SOP. So here, given the problem, and directly it is given as summation of minterms. So what does this mean? So summation of minterms of 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 10, 13, and 15. So this means the function f is having a value of 1 if the minterm, if the given input is 2, 3, 4, 5. So if for these minterms, the function value is equal to 1. That is the meaning of the function. So that is what we are representing in the K-map. So we have first step, we have to plot all the given minterms. So it is 2, 3, 4, 5, then 7, 8, then 10, then 13, then 15. So plot all the ones in the K-map. Then the next step is you have to do a grouping. So first grouping will be the group of a group. So 16, a group of 16 is not possible. So group of eight is eight. Either you have to have ones in two rows or in two columns, or either in the top row or bottom row, first column or and last column. If you have such ones, then you have to group it in group of eights. Now it is not available, so you can try for group of fours. So this is the first group that you are following. Then try to form another four group that is not possible. So you will start grouping twos. So second group is this. Then we can form group of four and five. Then you can form eight and ten as another group. So altogether you have four groups. Clear on grouping? Okay. Then here you can here you have another possibility for cell number two, but cell number two can be combined with cell number 10. Top and bottom can be combined, and three also has another possibility. 3 and 7 can be combined together. Okay, so 3 and 7 can be combined, 2 and 10 can be combined, but 8, cell 8 has only one possibility. Okay, so cell 8 has only one possibility. So the only possible group neighbor it has is 10. So this 8 can be grouped only with this 10. Clear? So if you make 8 and 10 as one group, then your group 2 and 10 will become, to make 2 and 10, you will have another group. And 3 and 7, you will have another group. So the number of groupings will become more. Okay. So try to form minimum number of groups so that you have lesser number of gates that will be used during implementation. Okay. So always try to form group which from a one which is having only one neighbor. Whenever you try to form groups and choose. So start from 8. So 8 will have 10. So it is over. Then you have 2. 2 has 3 as well as 10 as neighbor. But 10 is already grouped. So you can combine 2 and 3. Okay. So 3 is all grouped now. So you cannot, you need not worry about grouping 3 and 7. So you will reduce the number of groupings. Okay. Now you can write the product term for the first group. For the row, it is B, which is common. And for the column, the variable is D. So the product term for the first group is DD. Then for the second group, it is completely in one row. So the row variable will be retained as such. So it will be A complement, B complement. Yes, very good, very good. Can see a lot of answers. So A complement, B complement. And if you take the column, C is common, so C is taken. Then for the third group, again it is in the same row. So whenever it is in one single row, take the label of that row for the product term. So A complement B. Then if it is column, check both the columns, whichever is common. So it is C complement. So here the last one also, it is... Yes, very good, very good. A, B complement, and first column and last column, it is D complement. Clear? Okay. So this is for SOP. So suppose you are given SOP in terms of your product terms. So simplify using product, given SOP form. First step, you need to convert it into the standard notation. So hope you remember the conversion of SOP into standard notation, canonical forms. So first step, you have to introduce the missing variables. So if there is every term here, the given problem has four variables. So if it has four variables, check if there are four variables in all the term. So if you take the first term, only three variables are there. So one variable is missing. So if one variable is missing, one shortcut is always remember, if there is one variable that is missing, then that term has to be converted into two terms. Okay, that missing variable will be introduced as D in one term and D complement in another term. Clear? So ABC is now converted into AB. ABC is converted into ABC, D in one term and D complement in another term. Okay. Now the next term is also missing only one variable. So only one variable is missing. So you have to convert it into two terms. So the what is the missing variable? A is the missing variable. So A you have to introduce as A in one term and A complement in another term and write the term as such. Okay. So B complement C, D complement will be same in both the terms. In one it will be A and the other it will be A complement. Clear? Then your next term is AD. So AD, how many variables are missing? Two variables are missing. So if you have two variables that are missing, then you need to introduce the missing two variables. So here B and C are the missing variables. So how many combinations you will have? Four combinations. So 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Four combinations you will have. So the next four terms will contain, keep A and D as such, okay? A and D will be as such, and use these combinations to fill the middle B and C. So first one will be B complement C complement, second one B complement C, then B C complement, then B C. Clear? So if you have two variables missing, you will convert it into four min terms. So this shortcut. So the regular way is you have to introduce the missing variable and expand and write. Then the next is again a single variable which is missing. So here it will be converted into two. In one it is A complement, the other one is A. Then after doing this, then find out any redundant terms. So here ABCD is redundant. So you can eliminate this ABCD and convert every term into the corresponding decimal. So if it is complement, it will be 0. And if it is a variable, it will be 1. So for example, this will be 111, which will be equal to 15. So what we have got as the final term will be your summation of min terms of 0, 2, 8, 9, 10, 11, 13, 14, and 15. Okay. So once the given form is converted into min term, the next step is you can plot. So 0, 2. So always be careful in numbering. So 0, 2, 8, 9, then 10 is plotted, then 11 is plotted, 13, then 14, and then 15. So after plotting, you can do the grouping. So 16 group cells, total number of cells 16, 16 ones are not there. So you can't do 16 group. So 8 group, 8 is not also not possible. So we'll form group of 4s. So you can have overlapping groups. And in the four corners, so here you can see what is remaining is 0, 2, 8. And in 10 also, the corner 10, you have 1. So all the four ones in the corners can be grouped together. Clear? So all four corners will form one group. So altogether, you have three groups. So first, the group 1, which is blue in color, will have that product term A, which is common for the rows, and for the columns, the variable is D. So it is AD. Then for the second one, A for the rows and C for the columns. Then for the corner fours, wraparound adjacency. First row and last row, B complement. First column and last complement, last column, it is D complement. Clear? So add everything and write. So this is your simplified SOP form. So either you are given a standard form Yes. So either you are given standard midterms directly, you will be able to plot them, group them and write the simplified form. Or if they are given in SOP form also, you should be able to, yes, Jeevana, yes, right, ma. You should be able to convert it into standard form and then group and then write your simplified expression. Okay. Now it's an exercise for you. So do these two sums and give me the answer in the chat box. I want more answers. Or I'll call register number randomly so that you can give me the answer. Register number 86. I want answer from register number 86. 4086. Has he logged in? 4086.
Hi, Vikesh, ma'am.
Hi, Vikesh.
4086. Yeah, he's there.
He's there. Yes, hi, Vikesh. 4086. Try the first problem. Others wait until he gives. Then 4101, second problem. You can try second problem. I think Mahendra Reddy, yeah. 4101, 86 and 101. Yes, Vikesh. Yes, Vikesh has logged in. 101. Mahendra Reddy has also logged in. So others keep doing. Yes, Vikesh. Yes, Vikesh, you answer first whether you have you are listening or not. Eighty-six, Vikesh. Yes, 101, Mahendra Reddy. So both are four variable problems, and for both, yes, Mahendra Reddy, very good, very good. You are online. You can solve the second problem and give me the answer. Let Vikesh solve the first one. Quickly plot the ones, group them, write the product term for each group, and give me the simplified Boolean function. Yes, 86, no response. Vikesh. Yes. Yes, Damodaran, some doubts you have asked in WhatsApp. You can also solve. Yes, are you ready with the answers? Mahendra Reddy. Yes, Mahendra Reddy has given me the answer for the second problem is, so summation of midterms of 3, 4, 5, 7, 9, 13, 14 and 15. So, the answer he has given is, A, complement C, D. Okay, the A complement C, D is fine. Then A, C, D complement. Okay, there is an error. There is a trick here in this second problem. Altogether, most of you have tried giving five groups, yes? But actually there are only four groups because one group becomes redundant. One group will become redundant. So you will have only four groups. So for example, okay, we'll be solving. Okay, so you will have ones in the four centers, okay? Then in addition, you will have one in cell 3, then cell 4 you have a 1, then cell 9 you have a 1, then 14 you have a 1, okay? So this is how you have plotted. Now we will try to do a grouping. So initially always we started with grouping of the four ones. So the maximum possibility we will try. So you will do this. So it's fine. Then you need to try to group the rest of the ones. So when you try to group the rest of the ones, each of the one is a neighbor to only one one. So the possibility will be you will have one. Now this group of the cell 4 will be grouped only to this, then cell 9 will be grouped here, then you have these two groups and then you have to group this. Did you all get this? So hope all of you grouped it in this way. Yes or no? Yes, yes, very good. So this is the way you have to do. But there is one more condition. There is one more condition. Can anyone give me that condition which you need to? These are all, we call it as prime implicants. So altogether you will have five groups and this you call it as prime implicants. Every five product term you will have and these five product terms you call it as five prime implicants. Now I want simplified Boolean expression will contain only essential prime implicants. So when will prime implicants be converted into essential prime implicants? There is one more condition that you have to see for every group. Every group should have at least one. Yes. Fill in the blanks. Every group should have at least one unique one. Very good. Very good. Anandita. Every group should have at least one unique one. So the first group which we formed with four ones has no unique one now. Okay. So every other one has been grouped with the other ones. So it does not, we need not take it into consideration as an essential prime implicants for the last simplified Boolean expression. So you will have a group for this group, you will have a product term for this group, this group, this one, and this one, not for the middle four. Clear? So your final expression will contain, so it will be, so now you can check the answers. So you will have, so only four product terms. So after finishing the grouping, always check whether every group has a unique one, at least one unique one. Okay, so if it does not have any unique one, then that group can be eliminated. And Sai Vikesh, I think you have not solved it. So for the first one, did you all get this answer? So grouping will be for the first one, I think you had four groups like this, four ones like this, and you had one like this. So these four will be one group, and here you will have one group, and here another one group. So three groups. Clear? So this is for the first problem. Clear? Okay, a good try, ma. Everyone had given a good try. I'm happy about it. Okay. Okay. This is okay. Now we will move on to SOP. So I'm sorry, POS. So product of some form. Now the given problem is simplify the given SOP into POS form. So I want the answer in product of max terms, or I want it is in POS form, product of some terms. So it is, it should be simplified. So I need not have it in max terms, but I should have it in SOP form. So to have it in SOP form, you have to remember the way your truth table is being represented. So we have already seen F can be represented as summation of min terms of function whose values are ones. So if I have the given expression as 0, 1, 2, 5, 8, 9, 10, what does it mean? These are locations where I have ones. So I have ones in the truth table. Now, what will be F complement? So from this itself, what is that you can directly find out? What will be F complement? F complement will be those locations which are having zeros. So these are the locations where you have ones. So the remaining locations, so you have four variables. So from 0 to 15, find out what are missing in the given minterm and write it as F complement. So 0, 1, 2, then 3 is missing, then 4, then 5 is already here, then 6, 7, then 8, 9 is here, 10 is also here, then from 11 to 15. So these are F complements. Now, what does that mean? F complement locations are locations where you have zeros. So you have to plot the zeros. So 3, 4, then 6, 7, then 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. So now plot the zeros. So when you want the answer in POS form, you have to plot the zeros and group. You group the zeros just as you did in your SOP. So grouping rules does not change. So you have to group it. So here you have a group of fours. Then you have a group of four again. Then you have one wraparound adjacency. So 4, 12, 6 and 14. Okay. So all those together you form a group of four. So four groups. So now write the product term. So it is CD complement for the first group, then AB for the second group, then BD complement for the third group. Now what you have got, what is that you have plotted? Did we plot F or F complement? Answer please in chat box. What did we plot? We plotted F or F complement. Yes, F complement, F complement. Very good. We plotted only the F complement. So what is that you will have? Very good, Ma. Very good, very good. F complement, when you write the product term, it will be F complement only. So when you write the product term, it will be F complement. Clear? So F complement will be equal to CD plus AB plus BD complement. So to find out F, apply your De Morgan's law. So F will be equal to F complements the whole complement, which will be the whole expression, the complement. So when you apply, it becomes CD complement dot AB complement dot BD whole complement. And when you write the X, again apply the De Morgan's law, it becomes C complement plus D complement, then A complement plus B complement, then B complement plus D. D double complement will become D. So you have got the final answer in simplified Boolean function in POS form. Clear? So if you want the answer in POS form, plot the F complement and write the answer in F complement, apply De Morgan's law, you will get the answer for F in POS form. Clear? The other procedures of plotting, grouping, and writing the product term, everything remains the same for whether it is on whatever might be the change you do. The only change will be in the plotting. So clear? Okay. So what is that we have done? So simplification, so you have to determine the binary value of each sum term. So suppose the next one is given the problem itself in POS form. So in the previous slide we saw, given SOP form, you want the answer in POS form. Now the given problem is itself in POS form. So what is that you have to do? You have to find out the binary value for each of the sum term. Everything will be in sum term or it will be given in max term. So find the binary equivalent for it. And what is F now? If it is given in product of max terms, F is a product of max terms whose values are zeros. Okay. So from the given expression itself, you can see that it will be positions where you have got zeros in your truth table. So the given function will represent the positions where you have zeros. So you find out the corresponding binary equivalent, place zeros in those positions in the given problem, then group the zeros, then write the product term for each group and find. And when you write the product term, I'm telling it is a product term. Okay, the difference will be only when you are plotting. And when you group and write the product term, it will be a product term. And then finally find the F complement to find out the answer. So given, this is one example. So what is the given problem? It is A plus B plus C. It is given in max terms. So the given problem itself is in max terms. Okay. So A plus B plus C, then A plus B plus C complement, and A plus B complement plus C, A plus B complement plus C complement, then A complement plus B complement plus C. Now, for max terms or for your max terms, whenever you have a variable, it will be in normal form. And when you have a complement of that variable, it will be represented in 1. So if you have A, B, C, then it will be just 0, 0, 0. If you have A, B, C complement, it is 0, 0, 1. So here you can see C complement is represented in 1. Here then B complement is represented as 1. So if you take the corresponding numbers, so this is 0, then 1, then 2, then 3, and then 6. So it is a product of max terms of 0, 2, 3, and 6. So it gives the positions in your K-map where you have zeros to be plotted. Are you clear? Okay, product of max terms. F is given as product of max terms. So these are locations where you have zeros. So you have plotted those locations 0, 1, 2, 3, and 6. The next step, as usual, you can group them. Okay, this is one group of 4. Then you have a group of 2. Then you can write the product term for the first group. So entire row, which is A complement. Then the column, it is 1, 0. So 1, 0 is B, C complement. Then you can write F complement. The answer will be in F complement because we are plotting the zeros and we are writing. So it will be F complement. F complement equals A complement plus B, C complement. Now again, the same way, you apply your De Morgan's law and write A dot B complement, BC the whole complement, which again becomes B complement plus C double complement, which is C. Clear? So given, so what is that we have been doing for a POS expression? All cells that do not contain zeros contain ones. So given POS expression will be locations where you have zeros. And the rest of them can be ones. So if you want the answer in SOP, what you can do? So if you want the answer in SOP, you are given 0, 1, 2, 3, 6. So plot the remaining locations as ones, group them and write the expression for F directly. Okay, that also you can try. So if you are given SOP expression, all the cells that do not contain ones. So given problem will give you all positions where ones are there. The remaining cells will contain zeros. So from which you can derive the POS expression. Okay. So here is one example where we will do all possible changes. Okay. So using K-map, convert the following standard POS form into minimum POS. Okay, remember, you have to convert it into minimum POS. Then a standard SOP expression, a minimum SOP expression. Okay, already it is given in max terms form only. So as usual, you can convert. So this is the given problem. F is equal to A plus B plus C plus D complement. You can convert it into the binary representation and write F as product of max terms. So product of max terms of 1, 2, 3, 4, 9, 12. So what does it tell? These are locations where you have zeros. Okay. So where you have zeros. So 0, 1, 2, 3, then 4, then 9, then 12. Now I want minimum POS expression. The answer should be in POS. So since I want the answer in POS, I need to group only zeros. Okay. So I'll group the zeros. Clear? So 2, 3. So no group of 4s are possible here. Only group of 2s are possible. Now I can write the term for the first one, first row, first group, then second group, and then the third group. So whatever I have got, since I have plotted my zeros, what does it mean? I am writing the answer for F complement. So for F, apply your De Morgan's law, then finally you will get the answer in POS form. So that is your minimum POS form. Clear? Okay. Now the same problem, what is that we have to do? You have to write it in standard SOP form. So SOP is summation of min terms. So from this, already we have plotted the zeros. So what is it you can write? Can anyone give me from this itself how we can write standard SOP directly from this? Yes, can anyone give me in chat? So this is the K-map where I have plotted the zeros of the given function F. I want the standard SOP form. That means I want the function in all cells that don't have zeros. Yes, Satvika, very good, ma'am. Those don't have zeros. That means the remaining cells are all filled with ones. The meaning is the remaining cells are all filled with ones. So I can write summation of min terms of the remaining cells. So 0, 5, 6, 7, 8. Directly I can write the numbers 0, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10, 11, 13, 14, and 15. And later on I can convert those minterm numbers into its binary equivalent. So give the corresponding the binary equivalent for each one and represent them in the variable form. That I think you will be. So suppose I have 14. So it is 14 is 8 plus 2 plus 4 plus 0. Okay. So this is 1. So this place won't come. So 1 1 1 0. So if I have 1 1 1 0, then I can write it as A B C D complement. Okay. So every decimal number represent in 8421, then write the corresponding variable. Okay, if it is 1, the variable as such 0, it is complement form. Clear? Okay. This is converting it into standard SOP. Then minimum SOP. So minimum SOP, you know now the positions where you have got zeros and position where you have got ones. The minimum SOP is the default one. So you can, you need not worry about the zeros now. You can directly plot, group the ones and write the term. So you can group the ones. So this is group number 1, group number 2. Then 10 and 11 can be grouped with 14 and 15. Then 0 and 8 can be grouped using wraparound adjacency. Now I can write the product term for each of the group. And finally, what I get will be the minimum SOP. Clear? So given POS, you should be able to write simplified POS, then convert it into SOP form and derive minimal SOP also. So what is the summary? We will now summarize whatever we have seen so far. So if you want a simplified Boolean expression in POS form, you have to group zeros. Okay. And whenever you group zeros, remember you are writing the term for F complement. So write F complement in SOP form only. Okay. Follow. There are few changes that you can do. It is available. When you Google and find many videos, you will have different slight modifications of that. But follow one thing in common so that you don't get confused with that. So F complement in SOP only you will write. Then apply De Morgan's law on F complement, where you will get F. So your answer will be in POS form. Okay. So if you want the answer in SOP, you have to group the ones and write F in SOP form directly. So this is what we have seen so far. Hope you are clear with this SOP and POS simplification. Yes, ma, I want your response in chat. Yes, Ritika, clear. Okay, good. Yes, Gautam Reddy, Varshini, Deepika, Safina, Ranjani, Ramya, Vandana. Very good, Praveen Raj, Grishma. Very good, ma. Okay, so any form of simplification you will be able to do now up to four variables. Okay, now we will go on to, so this we will see at the end, another one example. So same, similar example, one more example. So we have plotted the locations where you have zeros and ones. So once you have plotted the zeros and ones, you can group the zeros and ones and write in POS form, group the ones, and you can write in SOP form. Okay, this is another one more example. This is an exercise. I think we will see at the end. Okay, now we will move on to the next modification in your KMAP, which is your don't care conditions. So don't care conditions are conditions that arise because of some input variables combinations which are not allowed, or it might be because of some combinations which we are not worried about. So for example, you can take the BCD code. So in BCD, BCD is binary coded decimal, and it is usually used for representing the digits, decimal digits. So you have 0 to 9 only in every decimal digit. So if you want to represent 0 to 9 in every digit in BCD form, you need 4 bits. So you will have combinations from all combinations, all 4 zeros, and 9 is represented as 001. So all combinations from 00 up to 9 are valid BCD representations. Suppose 10 is there, 10 up to 111, all ones. So these combinations are invalid in BCD. So if I'm designing a circuit for BCD, which is either as input or output, then these invalid combinations, I'm not worried about these invalid combinations, whether they are 0 or 1. So I call it as don't care. Okay. So when we design the circuit, it will be very useful, because if you are not ignoring those invalid combinations, then the circuit will become complex. And when you take those invalid combinations as don't care conditions, and when you simplify the Boolean expression, you will get a better simplified Boolean expression. Okay, and don't cares are always represented as X, capital X. So one example is BCD, and another example in XS3. So XS3, what is, do you remember what is XS3? One code, binary code is XS3. So anyone can remember XS3 binary codes? This, what is XS3? Yes, XS3 is where you will add 3 to the binary equivalent, and that is your XS3. So if I want to represent 0, I have to add 3 to the binary equivalent, and I'll represent the binary equivalent for 3. So this is the XS3 code for 0. So I have combinations above this 3, that is 0, 1, and 2. So all 0, 0, 0, 0, then 0, 0, 0, 1, then 0, 0, 1, 0. These 3 combinations are invalid in XS3. We don't use in XS3, because all 0 itself starts from 3. So from 3 only your combination starts. So these 3 combinations are taken as don't care in your XS3 representation. Okay, when we are designing circuit using XS3, you can remember this. So these are few examples where we will be using don't care conditions. So don't care, why do we call it as don't care? It is either represented as 0 or represented as 1. I am not worried about it. Okay, that's why it's don't care. So here is the truth table for BCD. So BCD 0 to 9 is valid. So here 0 to 9 you have. Okay, so from 10 to 15, it is invalid. The output of the truth table is represented as don't cares. So 0 or 1 is what we have seen. Now it can be taken as don't cares. Now how do we plot? What is the use in the K-map? So when you use it in the K-map, you have to plot the don't cares. And when you use SOP, in SOP, you will try to group, form group in using once. So when you form group using once, you can take the don't cares as once and try to form larger group. Suppose you are forming an simplified POS form, then you can take that X as zeros and try to form larger group of zeros. So this is similar to your joker when you play a cards, okay? So you can use the joker for any card. So the same concept is applied here for don't cares. You can use don't cares either as zeros or ones. Wherever you want to form a larger group, you can form larger groups. Okay. So first we'll see one example. So in BCD, so here in from the previous slide only, we have plotted the K-map. So the K-map here, 0, 1, 1, 1 combination. That is 7, 8, and 9. So 7, 8, and 9 are having 1s in the previous truth table. The rest of it is having don't cares. So 7, 8, and 9 are plotted as 1s. And the rest of the locations, we have plotted it as don't cares. So if we have been doing it without don't cares, we'll plot these two into one group and write a product term A, B complement, C complement. Now I have don't cares. I can take them just like jokers. So what I can do? I can form a larger group. You have to form a larger group, okay? Whenever you have a don't care. So your product term for this larger group will now be just A. See how simplified your product term has. We have eliminated B complement and C complement completely. Similarly, if you form one group with this one, if you don't have don't cares, it will be A complement B C D. Now, if you have don't cares, you can group that one with its neighboring don't care. Clear? And form a larger group which will eliminate one variable and you will have B, C, and D as its term. So these two terms are not needed. So you will have a simplified Boolean expression F equals A plus B, B, C, D. Now, one thing you need to remember is when by default we are forming a group of ones. And we are trying to form a group of ones. We are trying to enlarge the size of group of ones using don't cares. Suppose I have a don't care here. Okay. I am not able to group it with any one of the ones. So it is not mandatory that every don't care should be in a group. You can just ignore that don't care which is not grouped anywhere. Our aim is to group the ones and we have used the don't cares to enlarge the size of the group. Clear? So don't worry about any don't care conditions that is not part of any group. Okay? So don't worry about it. Okay, now we will do a problem with this don't care condition can be combined with any one of the models. So either it can be combined with a two variable problem or it can be combined with a three variable problem or it can be combined with four variable SOP form, POS form. It can be combined with any format. Clear? So according to the given problem, you will be either grouping ones or zeros. So try to form larger groups using the don't cares and proceed the problem as before. There is no other change. Clear? One condition, it is not mandatory that all don't cares have to be in some group or the other. Our aim is to group only once. So for this problem, summation of min terms is given. So our aim is to group only once. So don't worry if you have any one with any don't care which is not in part of a group. So first step, you plot 1, 3 and 10, which is ones, and then plot the don't cares. So 0, 2, then 8, then 12. Okay. So now you can group, our aim is to group only the ones. So 1 and 3 can be grouped together along with 0 and 2 to form a larger group. Clear? So all these four together will form a group. Then one more one is left out. What is the one? The which is in the cell 10, which is left out. Now you can see the corners 0, 2, 8. All the three corners are having don't cares. So you can use those don't cares and try to group this one. Okay? And form the next group. So your term will be for the first group. It will be A complement, B complement. Then for the second group, it is first row, last row, B complement, first column, last column, D complement, B complement, D complement. So your expression, simplified Boolean expression, F is equal to A complement, B complement plus B complement, D complement. Here in this example, you can see the don't care in the cell 12. We need not worry about don't care is don't care now. Okay, you don't worry about the don't care which is available in cell number 12. We are just using don't cares to make our group large. Group of ones large. Clear? Yes, are you clear, ma'am? Yes. Shall we proceed to the next example? Yes. Yes, very good. Okay, there is one more example. Okay, thank you, thank you. Yes, yes. Okay, ma'am. Next example, again, we will do the plotting. You should practice a lot for KMAP because you know the procedure, but just by looking after plotting, you should be able to group them. So the main problem is grouping. So you should be well versed in grouping. So practice, practice again and again. It will become very easy for you. So 0, 7, 8, then 9, then 10, 12. So all ones are plotted. Then don't care, it is 2, then 5, then 13. All the don't cares are plotted. Now the next step is grouping. First we'll form the grouping of the four cells, 8, 9, 12 and 13. Then again we have a group of four, which is in the corner. Okay, all four corners. Then you have 7 which should be grouped. One possibility, 7 and 5. Okay. So now the product term for the first group, the blue group, it is AC complement. Then for the corner group, it is B complement, D complement. Then for 7 and 5, it is A complement B, then D. Clear? So your function F is equal to AC complement plus B complement, D complement plus A complement, B, D. So in all these problems, the variables, I've always taken it as A, B, C, D. Suppose you are given W, X, Y, Z, label accordingly and write the term accordingly. Okay. Okay. Now we will move on to 5 variables. So hope till 4 variables, all forms of 4 variables are clear for you. Yes, use including don't cares. So now we will move on to 5 variables. So 5 variable, 2 power 5, it is 32. So when it is 32, you will have 32 cells. So we have 16 plus 16, 4 variable K-maps. Okay. And you have to be careful in the way we are numbering it. You can take the most significant bit. So for every K-map with 16 cells, you can include only 4 variables. So you have to remove that A, most significant variable, and take B, C, D, and E as label for these K-maps. Are you clear? So why we are removing the most significant bit is, when I'll just write the binary number system now. So if I'm writing 000, okay? So I will have 0 followed by 111, 4 ones. This is one combination. Then I will have 1 and followed by 000 up to 1 followed by all ones. So this is my binary number sequence. So the first few combinations. So what is the binary equivalent? This is 0 and this is 15. This number is 16, yes, and this is 31. 31 is all 151. So from this table itself, you can find out how numbering is there. So we can plot only 4 variables. So the most significant bit is A. Then B, C, D, and E are the rest of the 4 bits. So I can plot only B, C, D, E in my K-map. So in one K-map. So if here also you have the same combination, B, C, D, E. Are you clear with the binary sequence, ma'am? Yes, if you are clear with this, then I think Saujanya can switch off your camera. Okay, so are you clear with this numbering, binary numbering from 0 to 31? For the first 15, 0 to 15, the most significant bit A will be equal to 0. Then from 16 to 31, the most significant bit A will be equal to 1. Yes, that is what is being used in the numbering. So here you can see the first K-map. The first K-map which we have used will contain A dash. That means A value equal to 0. The second K-map which we have used will have A which will be equal to, with A which will be equal to 1. Clear? So 0 to 15 will be numbered in the first K-map. And 16 up to 31 will be numbered in the second K-map. Are you clear? If you are clear with this, then the 6 variable concept also will be very easy for you. Yes, shall we proceed? Yes, I want you, yes, no, in the chat box. Yes, ma'am. Yes, yes, yes. Okay. So if you are clear with this numbering, then we can, very good, very good. Okay, now we can plot. So from the given problem, 0 to 13, you can plot in the first K-map, and 21 up to 31, you have to plot it in the second K-map. Now, as before, you have to do the numbering. So I'm taking B, C, D, E. Be very careful in naming, because final answer, you will be using only these variables. A has to be common for the entire K-map, A complement and A. Now we will do the numbering. 0, 1, 2, 3, okay? 4, 5, 6, 7. Then last row, 8, 9, 10, 11. Then 12, 13, 14, and 15, okay? Then 16 comes here, 16, 17, 18, and then 19. Then 20, 21. 22, 23, then last row, 24, 25, 26, then 27, 28, 29, 30, and 31. Clear with the numbering? Okay. One of it is just plotting. You can plot it. So 0, 2, 4, 6, 9, then 13, then 21 has to be plotted in the next cell, then 23, 25, 29, then 31. Okay. Now you have plotted. Now for grouping, the rules for grouping, four variable came up, holds good. Now in addition to that, you should also imagine that one came up is over the other. Okay, one over the other. And you have to try to form groups of cells which are above, one above the other. So for example, cell 0 and cell 16 are neighbors. Cell 0 and cell 16 are just one over the other. I've just placed the first came up exactly over the above the next came up. So cell 0 and cell 16 are neighbors. 1 and 17 are neighbors. 3 and 19, 2, 18. Likewise, 1 is over the other. Now, when I want to form a group, I have to check if it is possible for me to form a group with the top or the bottom. Clear? So till now we have been looking into left, right and top row and bottom row. Now in addition to that, you have to see whether I can form a group with the ones in the K map above me, above the current map. Okay, that is what we have to see now again. Now we will see if it is possible for us. So the maximum possibility is 32 cells all ones, which will be equal to 1. Then 8 plus 8 and 16, 1 in one K map, 16 in another K map, then 8 in one and 8 in another. So 8 plus 8, 16, that is also possible. Okay, so we'll see how we have grouped. So before we group the 0, 2, 4 and 6, find out if the corresponding cells in the other K map is also having ones. So 16, 20, 18 and 22, they do not have ones. So you can form a group of ones, four ones. Okay, this is one group. Then the next one, group of one is 21, 23, 29 and 31. And before you conclude, check whether the corresponding ones in the other K map. So cell 5, 7, 13 and 15. All the four cells, if they are ones, then you can group them. But here only 13 is having a one. So need not worry. So this is the second group. Then 13 and 9. I'm sorry, I think we have made, there is an error here. There is an error here. This is not a group. I'll form the group now. So 13 and 9 is a group. So now 13, 9, if you can overlap with 29 and 25. So these two together will form a group of four. Are you clear? So it is not a, this 25 cannot be formed separately as a separate group. So all these four ones should be formed as a group. Now we can write the product term. So now we will write the product term for the first group. And if a group is found in only one K map, then don't forget to include the A dash or A, which is found in the top. Okay. So here this blue group is found in only this one K map. So your product term will contain A dash, which is common for all the four cells. Then you can include B dash. Then it is E dash. Okay. So So this is the product term for the first group. Then for the second group, which is found here, which is common, A is common. Include the term A because it is found only in this cell, in this K-map. Then include the row and column. So C and B, A, C, E. Then for these two, 13, 9 and 29 and 25, you cannot include A because one it is A and the other one it is A complement. So you cannot include A. So find out B is common, then D complement is common, E is common. So add everything and write, that will be your final simplified Boolean expression. A, C, E plus B, D complement. Clear? So before you group, always check whether the corresponding cells in the other K map is also having your ones. If it is having ones, then you have to take it as a grouping. So 9, 13, 29 and 25 are formed into a single group. And when your group is distributed among K-maps, you can eliminate the variable A. But if it is available in only one K-map, then you have to include A also. Clear? Okay, we'll see another one more example. So first step we'll plot. So you know the numbering, A complement is A and A complement goes to the top, and the numbering number very carefully. Then we'll plot 0, 1, then 4, then 5, 10, 11, then 16, 17, then 20, 21, then 26. Okay, now we can group. So here you can see 0, 1, 4, 5 is a group, but the corresponding cells in the other K-map is also having ones. So together you can form a group. Okay, then these two ones, 11 and 10 and 11, but 27 is not having one. So you are not able to form a group of four. So 10 and 11 alone will form a group. Then 26 is having a one, and you have the corresponding 10. So these two groups, these two ones can be formed as a group. And here, how will you find the corners? Wraparound adjacency. Wraparound adjacency for every K-map as before. Top row, bottom row, first column, last column, holds good. And in addition, the corners also. Okay. And if you have corners, so for example, or we'll finish this and then do. Okay, then next we'll write the product term. Since it is distributed among two K-maps, you cannot have A. So B and D, B complement, D complement. For the green, it is having A complement, then B, C complement, then in the column, it is D. Then for these two, A goes off, A gets eliminated, and the rest of the variables are retained. Clear? So your final F will be. Okay, so before we go into six variable, okay, suppose I have a one over here and a one over here. So four ones. So these four ones can be grouped to a, can be formed as a single group. Clear? So suppose you have had one over here, all the four corners you will group together into a single group. In addition, you can form a group like this. one over the other. That is also possible. Clear? So any doubt in five variable? So we have seen two examples for five variable. So you have to imagine one came up over the other. One four variable came up over another four variable came up, and do the grouping. Okay, now we will move on to a six variable example. One example, because usually six variables, it is very difficult. It is not, we can manually do. That is, there is a procedure. But more efficient methods like tabulation methods are available. So for six variables, it should be 64. 2 power 6, it is 64 cells. So how many four variable? You need four variables. So from this you can see. So this is one four variable, another third four variable. So again, how do we distribute the variables? So I have got how many variables? A, B, then C, D, E, and F. Okay, six variables I have. Now the same concept I will follow. I will distribute only the most significant bits. So AB will be 0, 0, and I have to write the binary equivalent from 0 to 63. Okay, so 0, 0, then 0, 0 up to all ones. So this is one combination. This is 0 to 15. Then what will be the next higher position? 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay, next higher position will be 0, 1. Here I will write all fours, then all ones. So I will have 16. So if I write 0 to 15, this will be 16 to 31. 16 to 31. Then I will write 1, 0, which will be 0, 0, 0 up to 1, 0 again, all one combination. So this combination will be 32 up to 44. 44, 35, 36. 47. It comes up to 47. Okay, so up to 47. Then finally I will have 1, 1 combination. Here I will have 4 zeros, then 1, 1. I'm sorry, all ones. So this will be the maximum 6-digit number. So from 48 to 63. Okay, so this will be my binary table, sequence table. So I will distribute AB now. AB will be 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. So four. Each of the four variable KMAP will have C, D, E, F. Okay, that is how it is being distributed. Now you can see how the neighboring cells are. So for neighbors, we need to always use gray code numbering. So for gray code numbering, you will have 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, and then followed by 1, 0. Clear? So that is what is specified here. 0, 0. So AB is 0, 0, then 0, 1, 1, 1, and then 1, 0. So this is the way in which neighbors, you have to imagine the neighbors. Imagine all the four KMAPs are one over the other. Okay? Or one over the other. And you can also imagine it as a cylinder. So it is, okay. So this one is a neighbor to this, then neighbor to this, neighbor to the last one. And also imagine it is as a cylinder. So the last KMAP, that is KMAP with 1, 0, is a neighbor to KMAP with 0, 0. Clear? So you have to imagine both. So whenever there is a 1 in one KMAP, you have to check the corresponding K-map in the K-map above it and the one below it also you have to check. Suppose you are in the first K-map, check the K-map which is below it and also the one which is here. Suppose you are having a 1 over in the last K-map, check the previous one as well as the first one. Okay, that is that is how you have to imagine now. So now we will go to one example. So even though they didn't give they have not given, suppose they have not given the variables, from the minterms itself you should be able to find out whether it is a 4 variable, 3 variable or 5 variable or 6 variable by looking into the numbers. Suppose you have a function which is having some number which is greater than 16, greater than 15 but less than 31. They have given just f is equal to summation of minterms of some numbers which is between 16 and 31. Then immediately you should identify that it is a 5 variable K-map. Suppose all the given minterms are less than 15 or less than that, then you can take it as 4 variable. Suppose it is less than 7, then you can take it as a 3 variable. If they have specified the variables as given in this problem, f of a, b, c, d, e and f, then take the number of variables as such, as given in the problem. Okay, so if any number which is given above 31, then it becomes a 6 variable K-map. So here we are given a problem, summation of minterms. Now, first step, you have to do the numbering. So before we number, you can see the variable A complement, A and B. So A complement, this is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, and 1, 0. Okay. So accordingly, we have numbered A complement, B complement, A complement, B, then AB, AB complement. So here you can see this K-map is a neighbor to this as well as this. So this K-map is a neighbor to this as well as to this. So just remember, it is just like a cylinder. So this K-map is a neighbor to this as well as this K-map. Okay. So this K-map AB dash is a neighbor to this as well as this. Clear? So you can see the circular relationship. Okay, now you can label the cells C, D, E and F are given in all. So you will have the label which will be common for all the 4 K-maps, same name. But numbering alone, you will have to be careful. So first cell will have the number as before. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, then last row, then the last before row. Then you have the second cell. So 16, 17, 18, 19. Okay, this is similar to your 5 variable. Then you have to come to the last K-map. 32, 33. Because this is 10, the next one is 11, 32, 33, 34, 35, within the cell, follow the same gray code numbering, 36, 37, 38 at the last, and then 39, then you can see 40, 41, last 42, then 43, then come to the previous row, 44, 45, then 46, 47, then the last K-map is this. So when you are numbering, be careful the way you are numbering because it is gray code. Okay. 48, 49, 50, 51. Then 52, 53, 54, 55. Then last row. 56, 57, 58, 59. Then 60, 61, 62 and 63. So numbering we have done. So once you have numbered, then you can easily plot. Yes. Plotting becomes very easy because the numbers are given. So you can do the plotting So for the first KMAP, you will have up to 15. So all those numbers from 0 to 15, you can plot in the first KMAP. Then you from 15 to 31, you can plot in the second KMAP. Okay. Then 32 to 47 is plotted in the second, third KMAP, last KMAP. And then 48 up to 63 is plotted in the third KMAP. Now you will do the grouping. So now you have to see the top as well as bottom, the corresponding cells in the top as well as bottom. So we'll check for the group, first group. So here you can see all the four corners and all the four KMAPs are having ones. So it is 4 plus 4 plus 8. Because A and B is distributed and is different for each KMAP. So you have to take only the row and column. The row and column numbering common for all the four KMAPs. So it is B complement, and for column it is F complement. Clear? So there are ones in all the four corners of all the four KMAPs. So all of them are grouped into a single group. Okay? All are grouped into a single group, and their term becomes D dash F dash. Next, we'll see what is the group. Okay. So here you have a group of four ones, 8, 9, and 12, 13. Check whether the group in the next KMAP, that is bottom and top. Okay. You have to check this KMAP as well as this KMAP, corresponding cells. Okay. Here, the corresponding cells are not having ones. Here also, there is, if suppose you have had a 1 over here, then you can group 4 plus 4 into 8. Now there is no 1 over here. So it is only a group of 4. Okay. Now we will write the product term for that. Since it is in only one KMAP, the group is distributed in only one KMAP, you have to include A complement, B complement, which is the label for that KMAP. Then C for the row and E complement for the column. Clear? Okay. Okay, again, another 4 ones you have. Now, 4 ones you have. Now try to form, okay, check the KMAP, this KMAP as well as this KMAP. The corresponding ones over here and the corresponding ones over here. There are no ones in all the four cells. So you can form a group of four with this, and you can write the corresponding product term. So corresponding product term, again, you have to include A and B because it is only in that group, in that KMAP. So A, B complement, and the column is E and F. Clear? Okay. Then, okay. Here you have a group of, you need to form a group for 25 and 29. So when you want to form a group of, group for 25, when you want to form a group for 25, there is a possibility of four ones. Okay. 8, 9, 24, 25. But, 29, either you can form it with 25 or it can be with 13. But you will reduce the number of groups if you form 29 with 25. Okay, 29 with 25. And you can see the corresponding cells in the other KMAP is also having ones. So these four cells will form a group. And since it's distributed across two KMAPs, A and B will get eliminated, and the row will have C, and the column will be E dash F dash. Clear? Okay. Then few more ones are there. 29 and 31, and you can see the corresponding cells in 61 and 63 are also having ones. Okay, check the corresponding cells in the other two K-maps. Cell number 15 is not having a one, and cell number 45 is not having a one. Are you clear? So before you finalize the group, check the corresponding cells. So here you have a cell, and here you have a corresponding cell which do not have a one. So you can just ignore those two K maps. So these two K map, these two groups together will form a group of four. And again, it is CD for the row and F for the column. Clear? So your final simplified expression will be summation of all the product terms which we have found. So altogether you have 3, 4, 5 groups which we have formed. So all the 5 together will be your simplified Boolean expression. Clear? So a little bit of practice. You need to do a lot of imagination before you form groups. When you are doing it in pen and paper, you won't be able to do it colorfully like this. So you should not miss any ones, and redundant grouping should be avoided. See that you are doing it carefully. Okay. Any doubts so far? Yes. So what is that we have seen today? A, B complement, EF. A, B complement, EF. Yes. So, in this group, so this is the group you want. Yes, Ritika? Okay. So, this group is found in only this K-map. Since it is found only in this K-map, you have to include A, B complement. Okay. So it's only in this group. The corresponding cells in the other two K-maps are not one. So you can form only a group of four ones. So A, B complement. Now, as before, you can write the common terms. In the row, since it's covering all the four rows, C and D will get eliminated and only the columns will be there. So E and F. So A, B complement, EF together will be one. Clear?
Okay.
So what we have seen so far is some four variable simplification using Boolean, using K-maps in SOP form. Given an SOP, the output can simplified will also be in SOP. Suppose you are given in POS, you want the answer in POS form, you have to plot the remaining cells, which are zeros, and whatever you get will be right, a term you will write will be F complement, and that complement you have to apply De Morgan's law, and then write SOP form. Suppose you are given SOP, POS form, that means they are all zero locations. So group them and write F complement and apply De Morgan's law. Your answer of F will be in POS form. Suppose you want that in SOP, then remaining cells, you plot them as ones, group them and write F directly. Clear? Then we also saw don't care conditions. So you can use don't cares to enlarge the size of the group of ones, but it is not necessary or mandatory for all don't cares to be ones, to be grouped. Then we saw an example for 5 variable as well as 6 variable. Clear? So please take down these problems. Thank you. and do a practice before the next session. We'll discuss the answer in the next session. Please don't leave. Write down the problems and then leave. Shalini, take down the problems before you leave. Don't leave now. Pranav, so who are leaving? And I will ask the answer from you in the next session. So you will start the session. Let me see who are leaving. One is Pranav. Pranav's friends informed him that he should be ready with the answer. Satish, have you noted it down? Noted all the problems? Yes, Kitika. Write down all the problems. So this is one example, one model for all what we have discussed so far. If you have doubts, you have to ask me. Aishwarya, completed 96. So if you have completed writing, Rohit, then you can leave. You have taken the screenshot. Okay. Okay, ma. So I want the answer next week. So we will start the next session by discussing the answer for this. So if in case you have doubts when you are solving these problems, you are free to ask me, because you all know my number. I'm in your group. You can ask me how to solve. I'll help you. Clear? Okay, thank you.